at Chuck Wendig. Yo, can you help me out?
Hey, what do you need?
I don't know if I told you, but I recently became a camp counselor.
That's cool.
It was going super well, but there's some kind of crazed serial killer roaming the grounds right now.
Oh shit. That sometimes happens.
You got any advice? They're all dead. Like, almost everyone.
Okay. First, I hate to ask this, but are you sure you are not the killer?
I can't be 100% sure.
Yeah, see, I wondered. Are you covered in blood?
No. Wait. Yes.
Is it your blood?
How can you tell?
Well, are you bleeding?
I don't think so, no.
Okay, let's see. What else? Oh, I know. Are you holding a weapon? Probably a sharp one?
Hang on, let me check. Is a machete a weapon?
In this context, yes. But it could be because you're just protecting yourself, so last question. Are you wearing some kind of creepy mask?
Like subjective creepy or objective creepy?
Generally, the creepiness will be broadly creepy like to the mass audience, so let's go with objectively.
Okay, so what kind of professions might be considered creepy?
Like, I don't know, a clown, or a human scarecrow, or a plague doctor from a long time ago? Wait, you're wearing a mask, aren't you?
Yeah, but I don't know if it's creepy.
Okay, let's take creepy out of the equation. What kind of mask are you wearing?
A wooden mask whose empty eyes drink in the light, whose jagged grin suggests it was carved, forced upon a wood, didn't laugh.
Oh! See? Yep. That's creepy. That's not even a job or anything, that's just... I mean, you found an evil mask and you put it on?
Alright, I can appreciate that, but I came for advice, not judgment.
Okay, fair enough. Hey, so I googled all this stuff, and it looks a whole lot like you are the killer. So, that's a plus for you.
Alright, cool. So, what does one typically do in these situations?
Well, good news is, you can probably feel free to kill more people. But there is some bad news.
Oh boy, let's hear it.
So, generally speaking, like most of the time, you're gonna get got. Probably by the last person you choose to kill.
Oh, you might be right. There's like 3 or 4 of those guys still running around.
Right, yeah. So if you kill all of them, the last one you go to kill totally turn the tables on you. But there is more good news.
Oh, sweet. I was hoping for an upside.
Upside. You won't just die. You'll get to keep coming back with new chances to kill. But, you know, more bad news too.
Jeez, this is a real emotional roller coaster. All right, what's the bad news?
So you're still probably going to die. So one option is you just quit now. You just like stop killing and go do some other shit.
So, okay, I agree that sounds really intelligent, but I'm kind of in the middle of the woods, so like, what else is there to do?
You can walk away and find a video arcade or maybe a fast food place. If you stay in the woods, the kids are probably gonna nail you though.
Right. The last one, Will, you said. So, like, just between us.
Sure, go on. Total cone of silence.
Like, totally hypothetically not doing it, but you said the last one would kill me, so like, so long as there's 2 left, I'm okay, right?
I mean, maybe. The math sounds legit. Is the math demanding you to kill them? Like, real talk time?
Not exactly. So like, I don't do what this thing tells me, but I am agreeing with a lot of what it says.
So maybe you and the mask just share a hobby. That's nice.
It's pretty good, actually. You know how when you meet someone and they're not friends yet, but you can totally tell you're gonna be good friends?
Oh yeah, just like total simpatico. Where did you find the mask?
In the woods, on a nature hike. Some crazy desiccated corpse was holding onto it, ringed by salt and bound with crucifixes.
Oh yeah, sure. I would have picked that up too, just for shits and giggles.
Like, I just wanted to do it for the story, you know? Like, just to say that I've done it. Anyway, I put it on and a lot of people started dying.
Yep, pretty classic case. So I figure you can kill maybe 2 more, But if you want to be safe, just go with, like, one.
All right, yeah, cool. But hypothetically, if I killed, like, three, how bad would that be?
Well, you'd probably die.
So yeah, here's the crazy thing, and like, get ready, because you're gonna laugh when you hear this.
Go on.
I killed all three and thought, huh, that's weird. Chuck said one of them would kill me, but get this, just listen.
Uh-oh.
This one I thought I killed way back at the beginning came back at the very end, all beat up and bruised and looking for vengeance.
See, that's a thing, yeah.
Anyway, this is kind of awkward because I'm trapped under a girder and a boathouse and all this gasoline is seeping in.
Oh! Oh. Hey, so, bad news.
Oh boy, this isn't great, is it?
You're on your way to an inevitable and electable end. But, good news maybe.
Oh, sweet, sweet. Hey, if I log off, it's because this broken flaming lantern on the edge of the table fell off.
Okay, yeah? So, here's the good news. There's always a sequel.
Sweet, sweet. So, hey, thanks for talking to me about it. It really means a lot. I guess I'll see you in 2-3 years?
See you when the lightning strikes your dread grave, pal.